safer and healthier this winter. Get your booster. And don't forget to get your flu shot, too. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
What the hell is going on? Well, we're about to tell you. KFI, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. KFI, AM 640.
KFI,
KOSTHD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County. Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Dodger off the hook. I'm Phil Hewlett from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. All sexual assault charges against Dodgers pitcher Trevor Bauer have been dropped. Bauer posted a 7-minute video to YouTube yesterday saying he and his accuser agreed to engage in rough sex at her request.
No sexual assault, active abuse, or non-consensual sex occurred between me and the woman seeking the restraining order. And today, the district attorney's office announced that they are declining to press any charges.
Bauer was accused of beating and sexually assaulting a woman that he met through social media last April. The DA's office was not able to prove the alleged victim's claims beyond a reasonable doubt. It might be months before Los Angeles County stops requiring masks indoors. Public Health Director Barbara Ferreira says the county's mandate could last through the end of April. She says she believes LA County's COVID transmission rate is still too high for people to ditch their masks. TikTok is making changes. The Culver City company is working to protect women and the LGBTQ plus community.
The short-form video app announced misgendering, misogyny, dead-naming, and any content that promotes conversion therapy is prohibited. The changes come as many social media apps have faced criticism that they don't do a good enough job of protecting their users from harassment and hate speech.
In a Kodiak reporting, Sean White is advancing to the men's snowboarding half-pipe final in Beijing. The 35-year-old finished fourth in qualifying after falling on his first run.
I was feeling that first run. Everything was clicking, and I think I just took that little relaxed approach to that last hit, and next thing I knew, I was like sliding on my back, thinking, what happened?
The San Diego native is seeking his fourth gold medal in his fifth Olympics. Meantime, Chloe Kim of Long Beach is moving on to the women's halfpipe final. She hopes to win her second gold medal. Southland weather from KFI, sunny and hot, 80 at the beach, low to mid-80s for Orange County and the IE, upper 80s for LA and the valleys. Right now, 59 in Buena Park, Irvine, 61. We're down to beach, 58, and in Burbank, 64 degrees. We lead local from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Phil Hewlett.
In North Hollywood, there is a work zone. This is on the 170 southbound from Victory to Riverside Drive. Two right lanes going to be shut down for road work until 5. Watch for delays in that area. West Covina, this is on the 10 eastbound at Via Verde. Clean up crews from an earlier crash. Other lanes are on the right shoulder, but watch for looky-loo delays as you approach. Anaheim Hills, there is a work zone. This is on the 91 westbound from Imperial Highway to the 55. Two right lanes are going to be shut down for road work. KFI and the Sky Hope get you there faster. O'Brien Vance.
I use CBDistillery.com products every night, and I happen to love the gummies. Now, with CBDistillery.com, I wake up less often in the night, I sleep better, more soundly, and it's a cannabis product, but it doesn't get you high. With CBDistillery.com, it's all about sleeping better, feeling calmer, although you couldn't tell with me, and dealing with aches and pains after exercise. And with over 2 million customers, CBDistillery.com is the company I trust, truly, for safe, effective, natural CBD products. And I'm not a natural kind of guy, but with CBD products, it's different. Of course, you don't need a prescription. For Valentine's Day, CBDistillery.com is offering 20% off a gift assortment of CBD products. And this offer expires February 10th. Use the promo code LOVE. CBDistillery.com, promo code LOVE, 20% off. That's CBDistillery.com.
This winter, we must all do our part to protect ourselves and loved ones from COVID-19. Getting vaccinated gives you the greatest protection against severe illness and death. But for the first time, everyone in the family ages 5 and up is eligible for the vaccine. If you are already fully vaccinated, get your booster to keep your immunity strong. Keeping each other safer is simple. Get vaccinated. Visit myturn.ca.gov to find a vaccination location near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
I think it's a super idea to get bowled over by going to Morongo to watch the big games. And now, the top 5 reasons to visit Morongo. Number 5.
Game day stay. Get a room and 2 tickets to the big game blitz for one low price. Call 888-MORONGO.
Number 4.
Big game blitz. Watch the big game on big screens in the ballroom. Food, drinks, and giveaways included. Get tickets now.
3.
Big game blowout. For every touchdown, $10 cash.
And the number two.
Because if you watch the big game on a small screen, no need to. We've got hundreds of big screens everywhere.
And the number one reason.
The big game is this weekend. And Morongo has big games for you to play, big prizes for you to win, and of course, big screens for you to watch.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times.
We've weathered this pandemic by doing our part to protect each other. So let's stick to what's proven to keep us safer from COVID-19 and its variants, like masking up in public indoor settings, getting tested before and after traveling and gathering, and staying home if you feel sick. Let's keep our immunity strong. Visit myturn.ca.gov or call 833-422-4255 to find a vaccine or booster near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Accident or injury, call Jacob the money, call Jacob.
It's a silent surveillance video footage of the vagrants.
Oh, this guy, watch the guy urinate. Oh, no, you can see the puddle at his feet.
Almost every segment has an oh-no moment.
Johnny Cash, weekdays 2 to 6.
You'll start shouting at your screen.
On KFI AM 640. More stimulating talk.
Astrologer Mark Lerner with us. We're going to talk about things to expect in the years to come, and then later on we'll take your phone calls here on Coast to Coast AM. T. Crane has a wonderful new Wi-Fi internet radio called the CC Wi-Fi 3. As a matter of fact, I got one for my mom, and here's why the new CC Wi-Fi 3 internet radio is so special. The audio is amazing, better than a smartphone. And it comes to stations all over the planet. It has more than 30,000 radio stations from all over the United States and the world at your fingertips. You won't have to sign up for an app. There's no tracking. There's no microphone. No ads on the screen. No monthly fees. And it has a full-size remote control. It has superior reception. And I mean great for the distance, by the way. Pulls in from your router. Let's face it. If you love radio, the CC Wi-Fi 3 is the one for you. And if you have the T-Crane crew answer any questions you may have, they're available to you. You can learn more and see the reviews by searching CC Wi-Fi 3 if you want. And the only way to get the CC Wi-Fi 3 right now is to call T-Crane at 1-800-522-8863. That's 1-800-522-8863. You can also visit them online at ccrane.com. Is your current home loan the right
finance fit for you?
Your historic low rates may be a great reason to refinance, but when matched with an expertly chosen loan from Loan Depot, you could be saving money and paying more towards the bottom line. Call a Loan Depot loan officer and ask about our 27-year smart term loan or our 10-year ARM loan. Get a great rate matched with a great loan by calling 866-888-LOAN or visit loandepot.com. At Loan Depot, home means everything. Rates are subject to change. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing opportunity. Send an LS number 174457. License to all 50 states.
So, I just picked out the perfect ring. And that night, my girlfriend started seeing ads for wedding dresses. I haven't even popped the question yet. Why is she seeing ads for things based on what I'm looking at online? I downloaded the DuckDuckGo app and stopped getting creepy ads right away. DuckDuckGo is the easy button for privacy. With one simple download, you can search, browse, and email privately. Have your privacy online for free with DuckDuckGo. Privacy simplified.
Coast to coast, George Norrie with your astrologer, Mark Lerner, graduated from Michigan State University, as my sisters did, with high honors and a BA in social science. In 1973, completed an intensive one-year training course in professional astrology and began his career. Hearing how they summoned other dimensions to grow thriving gardens in the barren soils of northern Scotland, Art joined the Finhorn community back in 1976. He came back to the United States in 1980. And eventually published the Boston Planet Earth Journal, which has reached thousands of astrological students and pros. It became well respected as one of the top periodicals concerning what they call mundane astrology, that's focusing on the higher destiny of nations, humanity, and good old Earth. His website, greatbearenterprises.com, link up for you at coasttocoastam.com. Mark, welcome to the program. Always great having you on.
Well, thank you very much for having me. It's great to be back on, George.
What was it about astrology that captured your attention back there in 1972?
Oh, boy. I told the story a little bit, but my dad was a doctor. I didn't focus when I was at Michigan State on following through with that. After I graduated, didn't know what I wanted to do. At one point, he got very, very ill, decided I'd go to Columbia University for a summer training in chemistry. And on the first day of taking a chemistry class in June of 72, as I was coming home, walked into a bookstore and I saw a book called Astrology, the Space-Age Science. And I opened it up, I wound up buying it. It was all about Copernicus, Kepler, Galileo, and Sir Isaac Newton. And the book was describing how these great physicists were fantastic before Einstein. But the biographers who wrote about all these great physicists and astronomers said they had one fatal flaw. They all were believers in astrology. And so that hooked me in right at the beginning, and that started all my reading in astrology.
Well, you're one of the best at it, and you make it very understandable for a lot of people. You've almost turned it into a science, haven't you?
Well, I always hesitate to use that word because fundamentally with science, again, I just brought up these physicists and so on, where you have all those rules where you can kind of reproduce everything in science, whereas it happens with astrology, we do have these orbits and returns. For instance, the largest planet, Jupiter, has almost exactly a 12-year cycle. The second largest planet has a cycle of about 29 years. And so astrologers, focusing on individual charting, which I've also done for almost 50 years now, or the mundane Earth, national, international astrology, we're always dealing with this history repeating itself. And I'm sure we'll just talk about that during the hour with all the things going on around the country and around the world. But the thing is that while these cycles do repeat, and we often have a kind of history repeating itself, you don't get all the planets coming back at the same time period. So it's very hard to sort of say, you know, scientifically, everything is back to where it was. However, if you were to change the definition of what really science is, I think astrology would be considered and will eventually be considered a science.
What contributes the most to astrology? Planetary alignments or star systems?
Oh, well, you know, if you go back a couple of thousand years, when we might call those people magi, astronomers, astrologers. The great thing about going back to Egypt, Greece, and Rome, and India, and China, a couple thousand years ago, they didn't have the smog, they didn't have all of these distractions. So the pageantry of the heavens, it was more of a connection to stars. They didn't have telescopes. I mean, of course, you know from your work on the History Channel and everything else that you've done, that if we go back to Atlantis, Edgar Cayce teachings, Rudolf Steiner, the Theosophical Society, a lot of my work with what's called LucisTrust.org and Findhorn, we get these records, right? What was really happening with the Great Pyramid? You know, what was Atlantis? ETs, UFOs, and perhaps there have been these great civilizations, which I firmly believe in. It's not even a question of belief anymore, is it, George? I mean, we have pretty much the ancient aliens and all of your theories and all of your guests. I mean, the truth is there.
We've had a strange couple of years, Mark. Are we going to pull out of it in 2022?
I realize I'm on it and I need to go away tonight, but I think that there's a reason because, I mean, I believe that there is a spiritual, invisible world above and beyond ours. I know you do too. Yeah. And you've written all about it and you've shared about it so much. And the same thing in my background, we're currently, for the United States, this has been a prelude the last year or so. During the last election, the battle between Republicans and Democrats, the situation was, for the United States, we usually use a chart for July 4th, 1776, the Declaration of Independence. Most astrologers use that. I've used that for 40 to 50 years now. And what two things have been happening. The outer planet Neptune has been opposite our Neptune. That planet Neptune, as astrologers now know, is in Pisces, a water sign. But when the country was founded in 2020-2021, our country has been going through what we call an oppositional polarity between Neptune, the ancient god of the seas, which has a lot to do with psychic sensitivity, spirituality, but also just vast forces with the economy. And with the pandemic and other things like that, the world with Ukraine and Europe and the Far East and North Korea and Iran and so on. When we have a long cycle like this of Neptune, the last time we had that, George, and that's probably this year, that was in the 1850s, right? Now we're moving into a new wave, and it's happening in the next 2 weeks, where Pluto, you know, the astronomers said, oh, Pluto's a dwarf planet. That was back in 2005 when they had their conference.
They kind of downgraded it, right?
Yeah, they downgraded it. You know, and even a lot of the people who wrote it at that point saying, you know, well, they made up all these rules. Well, the planet has to be bigger. It has to have these distances and all these other things. What they did do, though, when they demoted Pluto, which astrologers had never accepted, they raised up Ceres, the first asteroid, and said, well, Ceres is actually more powerful. It's exactly in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, where there should be a planet. Remember Tom Van Flanderen, the voting planet, this guy who passed away, bless his soul? And he was on a number of times. With you, and I believe with Art Bell before that.
Right,
a big part of my work in my podcast.
Meanwhile,
I've also been talking about, and I'll be sharing much more about this, Pluto coming back for the first time ever, and it starts January 20th and 21st, and
that's
then a second point of this wave in August, and then another point in December. So it's kind of like a football game of Neptune's been the quarterback for the last year and a half, which is a very dicey thing for the United States. Now it's handing the ball off to Pluto, the god of the underworld in mythology. And so mythology sort of converges with astrology and numerology and the cosmos and everything they're talking about. And now these two faraway planets for the U.S. are sort of been doing a number on us, and they're not the same thing with most people, all the listeners out there, you know, who knows their but what's harder to do for any individuals, or even a war leader, or what do we say, NATO, or the Warsaw Pact, or different groups, you know, all these different different entities, the United Nations, is how do you access and sort of control these faraway planets? They don't behave the same way as using your sun sign or your moon sign or the planet Mercury, Venus, or Mars, which are more individual and more personally usable by each individual.
When you come up with an astrological report, are they things that were given or could be?
Okay, let's get back to, we've had this discussion before, which I think is really crucial. So many people out there have this belief, a false belief of what astrology is, both in the religious world and in the scientific world, where they think astrologers don't know what the heck they're doing, because how can you believe that these planets far away are making you fall down a flight of stairs and controlling your
breath?
What it's all about is that at the moment of your birth, your first breath, this is why the time of birth is often very crucial in doing individual charting or you want to find the rising sign. What's important is that the planets are not making us do things, but what happens is that the chart, okay, the sun, moon, various planets, at the moment that something starts, is like a spiritual genetic code that's inside of you. So it's kind of like a resonance. So Jupiter is not sending down some kind of ray for whatever sign it's in, or whatever constellation, or Saturn. They're not pulling the strings, we're not puppets, okay? We have the capacity, if we learn astrology, but understand the principles of the zodiac, of the planets, and the sun and moon, and the alignments that they have, and these factors like Pluto or Neptune, whatever's happening for the U.S. or cycles for the whole world, then we can educate ourselves, and then we control our destiny. Or at least we have the capacity through knowledge and wisdom to do that a lot better than sort of sitting back and whatever happens, happens.
Next half hour, I'm going to ask you about some world events, Mark, through the eyes of an astrologer, and I want you to tell me what you think. Is that fair?
Yeah, sure.
And then we'll take phone calls in our last hour with you, but it is amazing. If you had 10 different astrologers looking at the same alignment, would you come up with 10 different possibilities?
I guess it depends on what question would be asked, okay, of those astrologers. One of the astrologers who's written a whole lot, his name is Rod Tan, and so he's put out a lot of books. And I remember him saying certain things like, when you do a chart or when you're looking at a cycle, you have to look at more than just where the planet is. In other words, what is the planet doing? What are the alignments that are actually happening? And in astrology, another big thing is how exact are the alignments? Are the alignments approaching, which is what's called a trine aspect, where it's getting stronger? Is it separating where it's already happened? And then also another thing that maybe a lot of modern astrologers don't always do, which I do, because I've had computers 50 years ago, it really depends on what tools you're using. And astrology uses many different tools now. There's what's called astrocartography. There's so many different tools that are different now. So depending on the question, it all depends on the tools that each individual astrologer used to get to the answer.
Okay, so it's conceivable you'll get different reports.
Right. Like, in other words, some people, like, for instance, I would just call myself, my dad was a general practitioner as a doctor, like what we call a primary care physician. And then you have an astrology specialist. So there are many astrologers who specialize in, say, financial astrology. And I know a lot about financial astrology. I studied so many things. The stock market crash, 1929. I'm always looking at Bitcoin and these different changes and the Fed and the Treasury Department and other currencies and so on. But I would not call myself necessarily the foremost financial astrologer in the world. I don't don't even know if we have one or two people, but we have certainly people who specialize in that. We have medical astrology, as I said, astrocartography, mapping, and moving charts around, whether for people or leaders. So I'm familiar with all of these things, and so if people come to me for a particular reading, whether it's, and I have seven different kinds on my website to do consultations, I can do an individual chart for just one person. I can do compatibility. If a person wants to know more about money, if they want to know more about relationship, if they want to know more about health, then I always get information from each person in their own words. Because fundamentally, I think of astrology, George, as I'm a problem solver. I'm a problem resolver. And I'm trying to understand what, when people send me information, how can I help them?
It's all stars, very scary.
Transits or progressions, which are their cycles, so that they feel more confident that they're going to get over the next hump and be more successful.
Mark, how old is astrology?
Thousands of years. I mean, back when we talk about the Old Testament and the New Testament,
you
hear the story of the three wise men or the magi. Well, those people were astrologers or astronomers. When they say, well, we've seen the star of the Messiah, the baby Jesus, and they follow, that whole storyline. We don't even know exactly what the Star of Bethlehem was, although we did, many people, including scientists, think it was a conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn, the two largest planets, and even with the planet Mars, there was a triple conjunction. There's even a book called The Star of Bethlehem, written by a researcher who's not an astrologer. So there's all kinds of fascinating things about comets, about all the sky patterns. They go back thousands of years. It's utterly fascinating.
Astrologer Mark Lerner with us. We're going to take calls with Mark next hour here on Coast to Coast. And after the break, we're going to talk about a number of world events and get Mark's thoughts on that through the eyes of an astrologer. It must be fun, though, for you to see these things happen, and God forbid, good or bad, to see them come true.
Well, I have always been an eternal optimist, even these days, which can seem very difficult because I grew up, as you did, with Walter Cronkite and Huntley and Brinkley
and black and white television.
Now with the 24/7, there's just so much of an immense thing, an explosion of information. I don't know if, our minds can handle all of that, but when it comes down to solving these problems, like in Europe, with Ukraine, with the Middle East, North Korea, I mean, it's tense and there's a lot of